Fluorescence is one of the most exciting skills of nature. Plants, mushrooms, corals, and even chameleons can glow in the dark when illuminated with UV light. They all contain fluorescent molecules that are able to re-emit the light they previously absorbed. So, can we also glow in the dark? In the 1970s, the green fluorescent protein was discovered in the deep-sea jellyfish Aquaria victoria, lighting up a previously hidden world. It suddenly made signalling processes in cells or gene expression in small animals visible under the microscope. Today, scientists frequently use fluorescent probes to visualise structures and processes in biological samples that are normally not visible to our eyes, but play a key role, for example, in the development of diseases. So why can't we use such fluorescent probes and simply shine light on us to see whether our cells and organs are healthy or sick, or to monitor the effects of a medical treatment? The reason is, the inside of our body is like the deep sea. It is ruled by darkness. The UV, or blue light, that is needed to stimulate most of the established fluorescent labels to glow doesn't even penetrate our skin. Thus, the fluorescent probes used to visualize biological processes also remain in the dark. In contrast to blue light, red light can pass through several millimeters of tissue. You can see this effect by placing your fingertip on a torch and notice how it glows red as only the red part of the light shines through your finger. Moreover, red light is less damaging to cells and tissue than blue or UV light, which can, for example, cause a sunburn. To see deeper into our body, therefore, we need red light and red light-sensitive fluorescent molecules that respond to it. In the Logic Lab project, scientists from across Europe are researching how to build a kind of deep-sea submarine with powerful lights that is able to reach deeper regions in our body and illuminate a world that we couldn't see before. The solution is to provide the fluorescent molecules with two red light-sensitive partners. Each partner collects the red light and jointly they transfer the light's energy to the fluorescent team member, which then glows blue or green when two of them collide. In the overall process, the red light absorbed is converted to blue or green fluorescence. Scientists call this process photon upconversion. Our goal is to establish photon upconversion as a new diagnostic tool that provides us with news about the status and functionality of the cells in our body. The technique is particularly advantageous as our cells usually do not respond to red light. That means we only get a reply from the probes and their answer clearly stands out from the background. Specifically, we're exploring if this approach can be applied as a first step towards early diagnosis of cardiovascular diseases. Let's dive together in the Logic Lab research and discover what we can do with novel upconversion platforms.